नमस्ते एवरीवन, वेलकम टू सेकेंड लेक्चर ऑफ मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। दिस इज राजेश। इन आवर फर्स्ट लेक्चर वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज मैग्नेट एंड अबाउट मैग्नेटिक फील्ड लाइंस। नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल फर्स्ट स्टडी दैट व्हेन अ करंट इज फ्लोइंग इन अ कंडक्टर इट क्रिएट्स अ मैग्नेटिक फील्ड अराउंड इटसेल्फ। द मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट वॉज डिस्कवर्ड बाय एच सी ओयस्टेड इन 1820। ही ऑब्जर्व दैट flow of electric current through a conductor produces a magnetic field around it. Let us understand this with the help of following experimental setup. Here we can see one circuit. Below that there is a magnetic compass, or we can say that there is a magnetic needle. Now here when we switch on the circuit, or we can say that when we close the key, then current starts flowing in the battery. It flows from south to north direction. Then what we observe that north pole of the magnet, it deflects towards the west. In the second diagram we can see that when we reverse the direction of current, then the north pole of the magnetic needle, it deflects towards the east. So from this experimental setup, what can be concluded that whenever current is flowing in the circuit, magnetic needle, it deflects from its usual north-south direction. Now to deflect a magnetic needle, we require a magnetic force. So as there is no other source for magnetic force, and whenever we are switching on or off the circuit, the magnetic needle is deflecting, it indicates that flow of current in the conductor is responsible for production of magnetic field. So whenever current flows in a conductor, magnetic field creates around the conductor. We can check about the presence of concealed wires with the help of this effect, with the help of magnetic needle. A concealed current carrying conductor can be located due to the magnetic effect of current by a plotting compass. For example, if the plotting compass is moved on the wall, its needle will show deflection at the place where the current carrying wire is concealed. Now I hope you all know what is concealed wiring. Concealed wiring, nowadays you can see that in your house, you cannot see the wires on the surface of walls. They are inside the walls. So inside the walls where they have moved from one place to another, that you can locate with the help of plotting compass or magnetic needle. Different. The pattern of magnetic field produced by current carrying conductor depends on its shape. Different magnetic field patterns are plotted by current carrying conductors having different shapes. We will now study the magnetic field pattern produced by a straight conductor carrying current, a circular loop carrying current, and a solenoid carrying current. Let us first study a straight conductor carrying current. The magnetic field lines around a straight conductor carrying current are concentric circles whose centers lies on the wire, as shown in the figure. In the diagram, we can see that when the current is flowing from this bottom end to top end in a straight wire, then magnetic fields are circular in shape and direction is in anticlockwise. Now you can do an experiment. You can take a cardboard and make a hole in the center, pass a wire and flow current from bottom to top. You sprinkle some iron filings, then gently tap that cardboard. You will find that the iron filings, they arrange themselves in concentric circles. So whenever current is flowing in a straight conductor, it creates a magnetic field which are concentric circles. Now the strength of magnetic field depends on the current which is passing through the conductor and the distance from the conductor. So it directly proportional to the current passing through the conductor. If we increase the current, then magnetic field will be strong. And if we move away from the conductor, then magnetic field will decrease. That is, magnetic field is inversely proportional to distance from the conductor, and it is directly proportional to the current flowing in the conductor. Now when we flow current in downward direction, then we find that magnetic field is in the clockwise direction. Now this direction you can also check by using a magnetic needle. If you place a magnetic needle, then the north pole of the magnetic needle will show the direction of magnetic field. So with the help of magnetic needle, we can plot the direction of magnetic fields. So whenever current is flowing in upward direction, the magnetic field is in anticlockwise direction, and whenever current is flowing in downward direction, the magnetic field is in clockwise direction. The magnitude of magnetic field produced by a straight current carrying conductor in a wire at a given point is directly proportional to the current passing in the wire and inversely proportional to the distance of that point from the wire. The direction of magnetic field produced by a straight current carrying conductor can be found out by using Maxwell's right hand thumb rule or Maxwell's corkscrew rule. Now let us first discuss Maxwell's right hand thumb rule. Imagine that you are grasping or holding the current carrying wire in your right hand so that your thumb points in the direction of current. Then the direction in which your fingers encircle the wire will give the direction of magnetic field around the wire. Now you can see in the diagram, I have hold this current carrying conductor with my right hand and the thumb is indicating the direction of current. So these curled fingers, they indicate the direction of magnetic field. So if you observe, your curled fingers are in anticlockwise direction and this anticlockwise direction will give you the direction of current. If you reverse, that means if the current is flowing from top to bottom, then your thumb will be in downward direction, and in that case you will find that your curled fingers are in clockwise direction. The direction of magnetic field can also be found out by using corkscrew rule. Imagine driving a corkscrew in the direction of current, then the direction in which we turn its handle is the direction of magnetic field. So in this diagram you can see that to drive the screw in downward direction, I have to rotate this handle in the clockwise direction. So the direction in which I am pushing the screw indicates the direction of current, and the direction in which I rotate the handle indicates the direction of magnetic field. So either using this Maxwell's right hand thumb rule or by using Maxwell's corkscrew rule, we can find the direction of magnetic field produced by a straight current carrying conductor. Now let us study the magnetic field lines produced by a circular loop carrying current. When the current passed through a circular loop of wire, a magnetic field is produced around it. The pattern of magnetic field due to current carrying circular loop is shown in the diagram. The magnetic field lines are circular near the current carrying loop. As you can see here, they are circular in loop. As we move away from the concentric circle, representing magnetic field line become bigger and bigger. So as we move from center onwards, what we find that these concentric circles, they are becoming bigger and bigger. At the center of circular loop, the magnetic field lines are straight. By applying the right hand thumb rule, it can be seen that each segment of the circular loop carrying current produces a magnetic field line in the same direction within the loop. Now this circular loop can be divided in infinite number of small segments. For each segment, you can draw the magnetic field line, and you will find that the direction of magnetic field line for each segment is the same. As you can see, we have taken here two segments, one is this and one is this segment. Now here we have drawn the magnetic field lines, and at this point we have drawn the magnetic field lines. As you can see that these magnetic field lines, okay, as they are moving towards the center, they are adding up. So at the center of the loop, all the magnetic field lines are in the same direction and they add to each other, due to which the strength of magnetic field line increases. So here I discussed about these two segments, like that you can have many more segments in this circular loop, and for each segment the magnetic field at the center is from this point to this point. The magnitude of this magnetic field line produced by circular coil carrying current at the center is directly proportional to the number of turns and the current I, and inversely proportional to its radius r. Now let us see what it indicates. Now as I move away from this segment, as I move away, then the strength of magnetic field will decrease. So here it is inversely proportional to its radius, means as the radius of circular loop is increasing, its magnitude of magnetic field is decreasing. Secondly, it is said that it is directly proportional to number of turns. Now here I have taken one turn. Right here I have taken one turn. So if I take two turn, then the magnetic field will be double at this particular point. If I take three turn, then it will be three times. So the magnetic field produced by the circular loop at the center depends upon its number of turn, and it is directly proportional to it. Also, it is directly proportional to the current flowing through this circular loop. So I hope we understand about the magnetic field lines produced by circular loop carrying current, right? So here we found that when there is a circular coil, then the magnetic field at the center is add up, and it is much more than in case of straight current carrying conductors. Now let us study the magnetic field due to a solenoid. Before that, we will first study what is a solenoid. A solenoid is a long coil containing a large number of closed turns of insulated copper wire. In this diagram, you can see that this wire is coiled. So this coiled wire is nothing but is a solenoid. So a solenoid is a long coil containing a large number of closed turns of insulated copper wire. The magnetic field produced by current carrying solenoid is similar to the magnetic field produced by bar magnet. If you see the magnetic field produced by bar magnet, you will find this same kind of arrangement of magnetic field lines, right? As the magnetic field is throughout same inside the solenoid, we say that there is a uniform magnetic field. So when there is same magnetic field throughout, we call this as a uniform magnetic field. So inside the solenoid, magnetic field is uniform. Now if we suspend this solenoid with a thread, then we find that as bar magnet always shows north and south direction, so this solenoid will also be in north and south direction. Now this end is in the south direction and this end will be in north direction. So solenoid, it behaves like a bar magnet having north and south pole. So which end will be north pole, which end will be south pole, or which end act as a north pole, which end act as a south pole, that can be find out using clock face rule that we'll study after some time. Now here the magnetic field produced by current carrying solenoid is similar to magnetic field produced by a bar magnet. The magnitude of the magnetic field produced by a current carrying solenoid depends on number of turns of the solenoid, the strength of the current in the solenoid, and nature of core material used for making the solenoid. So let us first discuss number of turns of the solenoid. As we increase number of turns, then magnetic field will increase. So magnetic field is directly proportional to number of turns. As we increase number of turns, the magnetic field will increase. Secondly, as we increase current flowing through the solenoid, the magnetic field will increase. So magnetic field is directly proportional to strength of current in the solenoid. And thirdly, it depends on the nature of core material used for making the solenoid. Now what is core material? So sometime we use some material inside this solenoid, or we use some material and on that we wrap the insulated copper wire. So the material which we use at the center is called core of the solenoid. So if we use iron, then that solenoid produces a good amount of magnetic field around itself. So the magnitude of magnetic field produced by a current carrying solenoid is depend on the number of turns in the solenoid, the strength of current in the solenoid, and the nature of core material used for making the solenoid. Now let us understand what is clock face rule. You can see the diagram. According to clock face rule, look at one face of the circular wire through which current is passing. So if I look at this face and current is passing like this, so you can see that this is clockwise direction. You imagine in which clock is moving, the hand of clock, minute hand of the clock is moving. So in the same direction my current is going. So at this end the current is flowing in clockwise direction. So if the current around the face of circular wire flows in clockwise direction, then the face of circular wire will be south pole. So you see the circular loop, and in that circular loop, if the current is flowing in clockwise direction, flowing, then that face behaves as south pole. Now here in this diagram, it is easy to understand, it is easy to remember, right? Current is flowing like this, and if I see, it is showing me this S symbol, right? From here, if I start drawing, it will be something like this. So this is what S shape, and S shape, it indicates south pole. If the current around the face of a circular loop flows in anticlockwise direction, then that face of the circular loop will be north pole. Now, current is flowing from here. It is going like this. When it come out at this face, when you stand and see, then you will find that here current is flowing in anticlockwise direction. When you see from here, it is clockwise direction, but when you see from here, it is in anticlockwise direction. So this face, it behaves as a north pole. Now you can see this is N shape, so it is behaving as a north pole. So by looking in the direction of current in the loop, I can identify whether it is south pole or north pole. This is applicable for solenoid as well as for single loop also. So whenever in a circular loop current is in clockwise direction, it behaves as a south pole, and whenever it is in anticlockwise direction, it is your north pole. The clock phase rule is used to determine the polarities of two faces of the current carrying solenoid as well as electromagnet. You can see the diagram. This is an electromagnet. An electromagnet is a magnet consisting of a long coil of insulated copper wire wrapped around a soft iron core that is magnetized only when electric current is passed through the coil. Now you can also say that this is a solenoid, right? In the previous diagram we have seen that circular coils, right? When they are wrapped around some iron core, then it becomes electromagnet. Now when I pass current through the solenoid, what happens? This gets magnetized, and because of that, this iron core which is placed inside the solenoid, it also gets magnetized. It starts behaving as a magnet. This is a electromagnet. This behaves as magnet when current is flowing through this wire, and when we switch off, then there is no magnetism in the iron core. The core of electromagnet must be of soft iron, because soft iron loses all its magnetism when the current in the coil is switched off. Steel is not used in making electromagnet because it does not lose all its magnetism when the current is stopped. So this iron core what we are using, this get magnetized when current flows through this circular loop, and it loses all its magnetism when we stop current. But if I use steel in place of this iron core, then there is some amount of magnetism left when we stop the current. So therefore we does not use steel, we use iron instead in electromagnets. The strength of electromagnet depends on the number of turns of the coil. If we increase the number of turns of the coil, the strength of electromagnet increases. Secondly, the current flowing in the coil. If the current in the coil is increased, then also the strength of electromagnet increases. And thirdly, it depends on the length of air gap between its pole. You can see these two diagrams. Here the air gap between the poles is less, and here the air gap between the poles are very large. So the strength of electromagnet also depends on length of air gap. If we reduce the length of air gap between the poles of electromagnet, then its strength increases. So here in the second diagram, the strength of electromagnet is more as compared to this first case. Now let us see the difference between a permanent magnet and electromagnet. The bar magnet is permanent magnet, and electromagnet is a temporary magnet. Its magnetism is only for the duration of current passing through it. So the magnetism of electromagnet can be switched on or switched off as desired. A permanent magnet produces a comparatively weak force of attraction. An electromagnet can produce very strong magnetic force. The strength of permanent magnet cannot be changed. The strength of electromagnet can be changed by changing the number of turns of the coil or by changing the current passing through it. The polarity of permanent magnet is fixed, that it cannot be changed, whereas the polarity of electromagnet can be changed by changing the direction of current. Now let us revise what we have done in this lecture. We have studied Oersted's experiment, how the magnetic field is produced around a current carrying conductor. We have seen the magnetic fields around a straight current conductor. We have seen Maxwell's right hand rule, or Maxwell's right hand thumb rule, or we can say that Maxwell's corkscrew rule, which indicates the direction of magnetic field. Then we have studied magnetic field around a straight conductor. magnetic field around circular loop, magnetic field around solenoid. We have studied what is electromagnet. So we stop here. Thank you.